Mark Levin.
Hello, everybody. Mark Levin here. I wonder what it's like being an Obama supporter today. Do they look more constipated than usual? Mr. Kalskrinner, let's keep a line or two open for Obama supporters. You folks can feel free to call in and tell us how your candidate won, how Romney lied, or if I detect that you have certain psychological issues, I'll try and help you as a public service. To watch the debate last night, and I must say within the first minute it was pretty obvious to me who was in control. You see, Obama has a problem. Everybody's saying, well, was he taking this? Was he didn't get enough sleep? Was he just being lackadaisical? No. He cannot defend that record of his. It's a disaster. Romney knows Obama's record. Ladies and gentlemen, you know Obama's record. I'm not going to play past audio clips of myself yet again, going down point by point the record in a very concise fashion in 30, 40, 60 seconds, boom, 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 unemployment, median income down. We've done that before here. Romney did exactly the same thing. The record's a disaster. And if Obama was there blaming Bush constantly, he would have destroyed himself. You can get away with that maybe on the campaign trail, but not in a debate. Romney and his people knew that. So what Romney had going for him was Obama. And on top of that, Romney had some basic positions, general positions, that he wanted to argue for, and he had another mission, to correct the lies, which he was obviously ready for. So Romney went in there with a plan, executed it as beautifully as you can execute a plan, and Obama went in there and thought with his swagger and his BS and all the rest of it that he'd be able to muscle his way through, but he couldn't. And quite frankly, I think he looked foolish. And near the end of the debate, yes, he looked tired and almost depressed, but I could tell he was biting down on his teeth. His jaw was tight. He was looking down. In other words, he was ticked off. Just remember how completely controlled his environment is. I don't mean the White House. I mean the access of the media to him is extremely controlled. 90% of his interviews are friendly interviews. The 10% that aren't are actually mistakes. They don't expect them. Minimal news conferences. Doesn't want to be asked about anything, and rarely is. So this is very new for him, very uncomfortable for him. And he's an egomaniac, and as I said before, he's a pathological liar. I believe people keep asking, this 47%, particularly his supporters or former supporters, why didn't he bring up Romney's comment about the 40% who don't pay income taxes and so forth? I'm going to tell you why. And other people don't want to tell you why or haven't figured it out. That videotape that came out on the eve before yesterday's debate, 2007, where Obama's going off about suburbanites, where Obama's race baiting, was a very evil speech for any would-be presidential candidate to give. He was a U.S. senator at the time, thinking about running for president. That speech, when he went into that debate last night, was hanging over his head, and he and his advisors decided Romney might use it, might not, but might, if he brings up the 47% who don't pay income tax. He did not want Romney to come back, if there was a chance that he might, and say, you know what? In 2007, you gave a very nasty speech, Mr. President, dividing this country along race lines, attacking the suburbs, and he could have pursued it from there. That's why, in my humble opinion, if you're strategizing these things, he did not bring up the 47% comment that Romney made. Because Romney wasn't going to stand there and again say, well, I was inarticulate. Or if he did say that, that wouldn't be the end of his answer. Because you could tell Romney's entire mindset last night was offense, not defense, offense. It was a superb display. And I must admit, I felt some relief. You know, others will beat their chest. Well, I didn't. Well, no, I did. And I was very pleased. But I need to tell you something else. Are you ready for this? In this audience, I think you are ready for this. It was a great debate. He crushed Obama. And we hope the next two go exactly the same way. And there's no reason to think they won't go the same way or similar.